extraterrestrial life. Now, scientists have found the strongest evidence yet that a planet 124 light years away could be home to life.
Back in 2009, NASA launched a bold mission with a single fascinating goal: to stare deep into one small patch of the Milky Way and hunt for planets beyond our solar system, exoplanets. That spacecraft was called Kepler, and what it found changed our understanding of the universe forever. Kepler wasn't built to roam or wander the skies. Instead, it was designed to fix its gaze on one specific stretch of space and scan non-stop for years. It was part of NASA's Discovery program, and it came equipped with some serious hardware, including the largest mirror ever sent into space at the time, and a massive 96-megapixel camera to capture the faintest flickers of distant stars. Why those stars? Because astronomers were after something huge. They wanted to know how many of those stars had planets orbiting them, and more importantly, how many of those planets might be able to support life. Over its 9-year journey, Kepler observed more than 500,000 stars and confirmed the existence of 2,662 exoplanets, entire worlds circling suns far beyond our own. And these worlds? They're not like anything we've seen in our solar system. Some are giants, much larger than Earth, whirling around their stars so quickly they complete an orbit in just a few days. Others are just downright bizarre. Imagine a planet where one side always faces its star, baking at such high temperatures that iron could melt on the surface, with seas of molten rock stretching to the horizon. Or picture a gas giant like Jupiter orbiting not one, but two suns. If you were standing there, you'd witness something straight out of science fiction, a double sunset lighting up the sky. But what truly secured Kepler's legacy was something much closer to home, or rather, much more Earth-like. It managed to spot rocky planets about the size of Earth, orbiting at just the right distance from their stars. Not too hot, not too cold. This region is called the habitable zone, or sometimes the Goldilocks zone, because the conditions there could be just right for liquid water, a key ingredient for life as we know it. One especially exciting discovery from Kepler is a planet called K2-18b. In 2019, two separate research teams found something incredible: evidence of water vapor in its atmosphere. That's a big deal. K2-18b is located about 124 light years from Earth, and while it's about 8 times Earth's mass and 3 times the size, it sits comfortably in its star's habitable zone. Its star, K2-18, is a red dwarf, small, cool, and the most common type of star in our galaxy. Finding water on a distant planet? That's not just exciting, it's a major milestone in our search for life beyond Earth. And that's exactly what happened with K2-18b. The very first planet in Kepler's habitable zone discoveries where scientists have detected water vapor in the atmosphere. Kepler first spotted this intriguing world in 2015. Since then, astronomers have been using space telescopes like Hubble and Spitzer to dig deeper into what this planet is made of. And the more we learn, the more promising it looks. So how did Kepler even find these distant planets in the first place? It relied on something called the transit method. Picture this: if a planet passes directly in front of its star, the light from that star dims ever so slightly. It's like watching a tiny bug crawl across a headlight from 100 miles away. Incredibly subtle, but with the right tools, detectable. By measuring how much the light dims and for how long, astronomers can figure out the planet's size, orbit, and sometimes even clues about its atmosphere. But here's the thing: catching a transit like that is really tough. Take Earth, for example. If you were watching our solar system from far away, Earth's pass in front of the sun would cause the sunlight to dim by just 0.008%. That's almost nothing. Yet Kepler was sensitive enough to spot even those tiny changes in starlight over and over again. And back in 2014, using this very method, Kepler made headlines with another jaw-dropping discovery: Kepler-186f. This planet, located about 500 light-years away, sent space enthusiasts into orbit with excitement. Not only is it Earth-sized and in the habitable zone, but new research from Georgia Tech suggests it might have seasons and a climate similar to Earth's. Scientists found that its axial tilt, the angle at which it spins, is stable, just like ours. That's a big deal because it means the planet could have a predictable life-supporting climate over long periods of time. And the search is far from over. Across the globe, research teams are diving back into Kepler's massive archive, rechecking data, fixing old algorithm mistakes, and matching it with findings from newer missions like NASA's TESS, Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite. That's how, in 2020, astronomers uncovered a hidden gem: Kepler-1649c. This planet had slipped through the cracks years earlier, but with fresh analysis, it was confirmed to be not only roughly the same size as Earth, but also with a similar estimated surface temperature. It's located just 300 light-years away, and it's now considered one of the most promising Earth-like candidates out there. These discoveries remind us that we're only scratching the surface. There's a newly discovered planet out there, and it's eerily similar to our own. Kepler-1649c is just a hair bigger than Earth, only about 6% larger, and it gets about 75% as much sunlight from its star as Earth does from the Sun. That puts it in a temperature sweet spot, possibly not too hot, not too cold, making it one of the more promising Earth-like candidates we've seen. It orbits a red dwarf star, which is the most common kind in our galaxy. And this little world adds another tick to the growing list of Earth-sized planets found in the habitable zone. That Goldilocks zone, where conditions might be just right for life. But hold on, before we get too carried away, dreaming of alien oceans and lush forests, here's the reality check. Out of 2,662 exoplanets discovered by Kepler, only 16 are actually located in this habitable zone. And even among those, a lot of them come with major complications. Some of these planets are tidally locked, meaning one side always faces their star, while the other is stuck in permanent darkness. That creates wild temperature extremes and makes it harder for life as we know it to survive. Others might look Earth-sized, but are more like mini-Neptunes, wrapped in thick hydrogen blankets that smother any chance of a cozy, breathable atmosphere. If that hydrogen layer is too thick, it can trap so much pressure and heat below that any potential water would be boiling or crushed far from life-friendly. And even though red dwarf stars are cooler than our Sun, they're far more active, frequently releasing bursts of intense ultraviolet radiation. That kind of exposure could seriously damage any developing life forms or strip away atmospheres altogether. So, on planets like Kepler-1649c, surface temperatures could range anywhere from minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit to 116 degrees Fahrenheit, colder than Antarctica on one side, hotter than Death Valley on the other. Not exactly ideal beach weather. Now here's the kicker. As of today, we just don't have the tech to fully examine these distant atmospheres and compositions. We can't yet say with certainty what these worlds are truly like on the surface yet. But don't lose hope. By analyzing Kepler's treasure trove of data, scientists now estimate that about 1 in 5 sun-like stars in our galaxy may host a planet similar in size and temperature to Earth. And since roughly 20% of the stars in the Milky Way are like our Sun, That adds up to billions of potentially habitable planets in our galaxy alone. Of course, Kepler didn't just look for life-friendly worlds, it uncovered a whole universe of strange planets. Some are hot, Jupiter's massive gas giants made mostly of hydrogen and helium that orbit extremely close to their stars, whipping around them in just days. They're way too hot and wild for life, but they're fascinating in their own right. In the end, Kepler gave us more than numbers. It rewrote our sense of what's out there, revealing a galaxy full of weird, wonderful, and sometimes surprisingly familiar worlds. And maybe, just maybe, one of them is a second Earth. Let's talk about one of the most intriguing finds from the Kepler mission, a mysterious gas giant called KOI-5AB. Now, this planet was actually spotted way back in 2009 during the early days of Kepler's planet hunting journey. In fact, it was only the second possible planet the telescope ever detected. But then it vanished from the spotlight. Why? Well, for two reasons. First, Kepler was collecting a mind-blowing amount of data, so things could easily slip through the cracks. Second, astronomers realized the star KOI-5A, the one the planet was supposedly orbiting, wasn't alone. It had a companion star, and that complicated the whole picture. As researchers dug deeper, they found out this system was even trickier than they thought. By 2014, it became clear that KOI-5 was actually a three-star system. That raised a big question. Was KOI-5AB a real planet, or just a trick of the light caused by one of the other stars? Fast forward a few years, enter NASA's TESS satellite, a next-gen planet hunter. With fresh data and sharper tools, astronomers were finally able to confirm KOI-5AB is real. And what a wild find it is. Finding a planet in a triple star system is rare. These kinds of systems are chaotic, and it's tough for a planet to settle into a stable orbit without being flung out into space. But KOI-5AB managed to hold on, and that makes it a goldmine for understanding how planets form in extreme environments. Kepler didn't just find gas giants, it also revealed other exotic types of planets, super-Earths, planets bigger than Earth but smaller than Neptune, made of rock, gas, or a mix of both, lava planets scorching hot worlds with molten surfaces orbiting dangerously close to their stars. Some of these may be what scientists call Schuthonian planets, the leftover cores of hot Jupiters that had their atmospheres stripped away over time. And then there are the mysterious Trojan planets, theoretical worlds that share orbits with bigger planets. None have been confirmed yet, but they remain an exciting possibility. After almost a decade of peering into the cosmos, Kepler's mission came to a graceful end on October 30, 2018, when it ran out of fuel. NASA sent a final goodnight command a month later, officially retiring the telescope. Fittingly, that moment came exactly 338 years after the death of Johannes Kepler, the astronomer whose name the mission proudly carried. Even though the telescope is no longer operational, its legacy is far from over. The discoveries Kepler left behind are still being studied today, and they're paving the way for next-generation observatories. One of the most exciting is the James Webb Space Telescope, which launched in 2021. With its powerful instruments, Webb will take a much closer look at some of Kepler's most intriguing targets. We're hoping it'll help answer one of humanity's biggest questions. Are we alone in the universe? What do you think? Are there stranger, Earth-like worlds still buried in Kepler's mountain of data? Have we only scratched the surface? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to stay curious.